Sukhinda ji, all the dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen, at the outset I would like to congratulate Gautam, Saigi and Dweep for creating this report which shows all concern about endangered future of Mumbai's open space. As rightly said by Mr. Desai, Mr. Kulkarni's recipe was really strong. It was a bit more for a day to sink in. But I think right thing at right time. I would like to congratulate ORF for all the work it has done in past few years. The snapshot we saw showcased many reports, and I think all the issues which are taken up by ORF are the issues which concern a common citizen of Mumbai, Maharashtra and India. Be it about open spaces, be it about the heritage architecture, be it about the railways, commuters, be it about the drought in Marathwada or about SRA. I think we really need this perspective. Normally in government we only carry out financial audit of our schemes, and there is no dispensation of carrying social audit of the government schemes. And I would say that these reports are the social audit of government schemes, of government policies. They not only tell us what has gone wrong, but also pave a way towards correcting the policies, the initiatives, the laws. And I think this report on endangered future of Mumbai's open space has come on very opportune time. The development plan for Mumbai city is in the last phase of approval. Although I would have been more happy if this report would have gone to the people, especially the officials and members of the corporation, when corporation deliberated on the development plan. It would have been a guiding force for them to take informed decisions. Nevertheless, I think even today it's very opportune time, because now with all the recommendations of the municipal corporation, this development plan has reached the government of Maharashtra. And we have also decided a very ambitious timeline for us. In fact, the government has 18 months to give final approval to this plan. But we wish to do it in less than 6 months. So by February or March, we feel that Mumbai should get its new development plan. Having said that, looking towards the past history, what has really went in, if you look at it, normally preparation of development plan and its approval has been a generational activity. A development plan is a plan for 20 years. But it used to take 10 to 12 years from start to end to create a development plan. And by the time development plan was cleared, all the spaces, different reservations, either would have been encroached or their user has been changed. So where you have kept open space, you find a building. Where you have kept a space for a hospital, you find a hotel. This time we decided, and especially after I took over, there were many development plans which were pending before the government for 8 to 10 years. In less than 1.5 years, I cleared almost all, and the number is more than 70. And now, except for the Mumbai plan, no plan is pending with the government. So, on one hand, we have started this process of accelerating clearance of development plan. On the other hand, there has always been a disconnect between a plan and development. Plan was a document to be kept inside locker, and development was a prerogative of either corporation or elected representative as they feel. We wanted to break this disconnect. It was never thought, even if we look at the 1992 DP, Ashish can tell, or Ms. Narvekar, somebody from corporation can tell me, but I think we could implement it to 20%, not more than that. Just 20% of the DP is implemented. We require more and more instrument to implement the DP. It's not just about keeping open spaces. It's not just about keeping reservations for gardens. Who is going to create it? How you are going to create it? And how are you going to compensate the person whose land you have kept reserved for a garden or as open space? We need to create more and more instrument. We took a decision. Initially, if you keep a reservation of any public place on anybody's land, his first attempt would be to how to get rid of that reservation. And if he cannot, then he ensures that it is encroached and it is sold to somebody so that the reservation is not implemented. But if we compensate him properly, if somebody feels that, look, there's a reservation on my land, but I'm getting more, then the person will be very happy to hand over that reservation. So what we have decided is to give more through TDR. We created a new dispensation in which we decided to give more. If you part with your land, you will get twice the TDR, because the rate of TDR is always low. So if you give one time TDR, then it cannot match the amount of the price of the plot. So we started giving that. Also, the new accommodation reservation policy which you brought in is also very dynamic. So it actually ensures and encourages a person to give back. Because by giving open space to the city, he is getting more, or at least adequately compensated. And that also is adding value to his property. And the result is, now in various development plans, after these dispensations, people are no more visiting our offices saying, please change the reservation on our plot. Because now they know that they have some dispensation through which they will be adequately compensated. I think this disconnect is breaking. And for the new development plan of Mumbai, and also for the new development plan of MMR region, we require to adopt these policies. So let me assure you that the new plan, as rightly said by Saili, that it has many ambitious achievements to reach, but will not downgrade it. Will create new instruments to achieve it. I feel that planning is a process where you not only create beautiful things, but planning is also a process which paves a way to reach towards creating these beautiful things. And we'll find out those tools so that all these things can be achieved. And Mumbai will certainly, and also the MMR will certainly see more and more open spaces being created. One thing I totally agree that at certain point of time, we have to look at the PPP policies. In past, they have failed because they were lopsided. The policies were only to benefit the investor. As rightly said by our Honorable Prime Minister, in the PPP, we also need to add one more P. Because in PPP, it is a public-private partnership where public is government. Where are the people? So if any policy, we have more participation, if we add people to it. And the major failure of PPP policies was because of non-participative nature. Where there was no people's participation. So I think if we ensure more and more people's participation into the policies where people themselves are part of creating such open spaces and financing them, I think we'll find good ways, efficient ways to not only create public spaces, but also to keep them accessible to a large amount of people, because it's quite startling statistics when we look at it that 17% of the open spaces are not accessible to 99.9% of the people. So I would not term them as open spaces. I would say that they are private open spaces, limitedly open for few people. So now let's think of a policy where everybody gets access, and that's what when Ashish came to me and he opted a stay on the policy, that was a major concern, that the policy was again all about creating private open spaces and we wanted public open spaces to come. So I think this report will also guide us in creating efficient policies through our development control rules, which we will publish with our development plan. The concerns which are raised by Mr. Kulkarni are absolutely right. Places like Azad Maidan, August Kranti Maidan are real heritage of Mumbai. I would like to assure him that the government will take care of that. Will direct the municipal corporation to look into it and will ensure that these spaces don't lose their heritage value. One more thing which you pointed out is very important. It's about urban art commission. And you have rightly said that the Delhi Urban Art Commission has done a very good job. In fact, there was a thought process earlier that public places should not have beauty. So if you create a public office, it has to be like a railway bogie or a footpath or a bench. Has to be very regressive type of architecture. But I think you don't require more money to bring aesthetics. You only need policy. And through policy, you can bring aesthetics to the public places. So I assure you that the government will create Urban Art Commission for Mumbai in 1 month. I think I may not go in all 6 points you have raised, but I would certainly like to take the note of those points from you, and I assure you that we will work on it. I assure ORF and all the people who are present here, because you represent Mumbai. So it's my assurance that we'll see to it that in Maharashtra we create more and more urban spaces. Our policies and instruments will be towards creating more urban spaces with accessibility to each and every citizen of Maharashtra. And for that, I assure you that this report will not be just another document. Mr. Kulkarni, you were right when you said that we need more and more intellect into our governance. The problem is conflicting intellect. There are so many reports created, and if you put together all the reports, they contradict each other. And having been a public office for so many years and being Chief Minister of Maharashtra for almost 3 years, I sometimes fail to understand whom to follow. Whatever policy you follow, in Mumbai there are at least 5 people who say this is an incorrect policy and we have a correct policy. But I think I have gone through your reports and they are quite practical. So as of now, I think we will really try to get the clue from these reports. We will try to implement the principles of these reports into our planning system. I finally would like to congratulate the authors who have researched for more than a year to create this wonderful report. And I also congratulate ORF, and we look forward for more and more reports, more and more interaction, more and more work on the ground. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra.